Hello, everyone. I wanted to do a soft-spoken version of my other video where I play with cat toys. This is what you would call a habit of mine. Good habit. While I am watching TV, which I always love to do in the evening with my husband, instead of reaching for the candy or some snack, I will pick up my handy dandy cat toys. Cat toys. I don't know why it came out that way. I am not a stutter. But these really, really help me to relieve anxiety if I'm having it, and I don't often have severe anxiety, but just sometimes a need to wind down and forget about everything, and so that's what television watching is all about. But this is about having something to do with my hands rather than my mouth. And this is a very rewarding relieving and helps me wind down while I watch TV. So, I discovered these one day at Walmart. I brought it home for my cat. This is the one. We bought this right at Christmas time, thinking I would give it to my kitties for Christmas. Lo and behold, they don't like them. So, I was extremely disappointed about that. They say on the little card that comes on it that cats like to kick them, hold the top with their hand, their paws, their hands with their paws, and then kick the bottom. And they also say that there is catnip in this, so your cats are supposed to be attracted to it. Well, apparently my cats don't care for catnip, and they were afraid. They were afraid of these. So, quickly, I adopted them for myself, because surely I was attracted to them for my own reasons. Even if the cat didn't want them. So, this is the sound. This is the thing that I love. And occasionally, I will take these little feathers and tickle my face with them. In my New Year's video, I opened up this ribbon. And in my last video, with no talking in it, I opened up the ribbon to show the batting that's on the inside. And what's interesting is how simply made these are. They are so simple. that I think anyone who knows the littlest bit about sewing could quite easily replicate this. So, all you would have to do is, well, if you spread this out, you would just have two rectangular pieces of material, soft on one side, rough on the other. And then, of course, it would be inside out when you began, and you would sew your seams together along the sides of your rectangle. Simple, simple. But what they do is they add a thin plastic sheet on either side, much like you would do if you were making a quilt, except you're not adding cushion, you're just adding plastic. So that's on there with your cloth rectangle. Sew the edges up. What I'm not sure about is how do they then turn it back inside out once they have it sewn up. I imagine if these are manufactured in a company plant, they probably have a way to just shoot that thing through, you know, and turn it back inside right, outside right. Then simply, they would, I mean, this is really just like you were wrapping a present, a circular, cylindrical present for Christmas or a birthday. Just wrap it around it. They fill this with simple pillow batting. That's what it's called, pillow batting. So, I don't know if they have a pre-shaped batting that they put in there, or what they do quite, but that's what it's stuffed with. So basically you have a rectangular couple of pieces of cloth lined with plastic and filled with a pillow batten. Then, just like a gift, tie it at the ends. Gather it up and tie it at the ends. I suppose that they go ahead and just stick the feathers in afterwards and glue them. I'm pretty sure they're just glued. This one, they both have mice, but this one is more of your typical cartoon mice that have the bulgy eyes and the exaggerated ears and funny little body. And oh, this one has a little friend, little tiny mouse with his own tiny little heart. This one loves the little mouse so much more that he has, she or she has all these hearts. Isn't that sweet? Okay, whereas the first one I got in December has a tad bit more realistic looking mouse, even though it's cartoon, it's not funnily exaggerated. humorously. I shouldn't say funnily. I don't think funnily is a word. Okay, so, but the shape of its head is a little more realistic to a real mouse, and his little nose, though, wouldn't be that big. Eyes, whiskers, they all have whiskers, so that's nice. Ears are a little bit exaggerated. But it's a cute mouse, isn't it? Big tail. Mostly the dimensions are accurate. And the back of this one. Red that blonde girls can wear. If you don't know me by now, I do have a preoccupation with colors matching and not clashing. And that includes the world of fashion and beauty for women. And so the orangey reds don't look as nice on a darker skinned person or a, well, let's just call it the season. And if you're a winter and you have dark hair and fair features, you tend to be able to wear more jewel tones. The perfect example is the difference between these two kinds of red right here. So, a lot of women that are blonde say, oh no, I could never wear red. Well, it depends on the kind of red that you choose. Now, me being a winter and more fair-skinned, I can wear this kind of red next to my skin, my neck, black. Crimson type of reds are my colors. But somebody who is more a summery, blondish person can more easily wear reds that have some orange and cooler colors mixed in that. That's one unintentional lesson in coloring. Now here on the other side, we have a red that is not so orangey, but more pinkish. I can wear that color because it leans more towards the color of the watermelon's flesh. Inside a watermelon is a more pinkish red, which is very different than an orangey red. And you might think these are the same reds, but they're not. All it takes is just a shade different, with a little bit of a different hue, and it completely changes your skin complexion. So, all that being said, so many women these days have actually learned about cool and warm skin tone differences. But, yeah, so this color is my color, and this color is my color. And yet, if it's not on an individual, do very nicely go together. That's a whole different issue than trying to wear clothes that go with your skin. And in decorating your home, there's a lot more liberty. For instance, blue of this background cloth does not necessarily clash with this light blue, but the light blue and this dark blue, though they don't clash, don't exactly match either. So, and red and navy blue go together very well. The deeper reds. Some of you have asked for scratching and tapping. Tapping I don't usually like to do or even listen to, but this kind of scratching I think is kind. Especially if it has such a texture like this. And included is the occasional crinkle that comes with it. But this is something that I also do while sitting watching TV, is scratching. Because inadvertently, it will crinkle as well. So, this side of the cat toy has the more rough burlap-y type of material. This side is much softer. So scratching it does not make a sound, but rubbing it does. It's a very nice velour. Not to be infused with gingham. Gingham is not rectangular. I mean, gingham is not diamond shaped. Gingham is squares. This is slightly diamond shaped. Plaid can be squares too, but it usually has another pattern in it with lines like this. Whereas gingham has no other pattern except squares, and it's usually dark, light, dark, light in its squares. Gingham tends to be smaller squares. Also, plaid is a little bit larger. So, I'm just thinking of things to say. I don't really have anything important. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. Showing the rest of them are folded up on the ends. Looks like we're missing some feathers on the end of that one. Okay, so sometimes I will squeeze really hard while I'm sitting watching TV, and then slowly let go. The other day, my husband, he grabs this from me. Crazy fast crinkles. And I was laughing and I'm going, you don't know how to do that right. You couldn't even do it gently if you wanted to. And he took the bait. He took the challenge. And he picked it up. And most seriously, just for my approval, and because he loved the challenge. Seems like all you need to do is tell a man that he can't do something, and he'll find a way to do it. So, sometimes we can use reverse psychology. You notice these feathers here are a little bit darker than the ribbon and the back. See, a lot of you may know that I am really big on the visually pleasing, and I can be somewhat of a perfectionist, but in my videos and just let them slide. Now see, obviously they use the same feathers for all of their cat toys. They just switch out the contrasting color depending on what they have on the back. I say mice, but that's not what I meant. Cat toys. So this one matches the back, and this one matches the front. So obviously there's quite a bit of liberty that can be taken. Sometimes when I'm sitting in my recliner watching TV, I will also do this. See how far I can go. Oh my. Yeah. Here's the thing is, I wouldn't normally do a video like this because it's sort of along the lines of what I call strange ASMR, where people weirdly caress items for the camera. And I think it's really funny. I am making an exception, and I'm weirdly caressing items in front of the camera as a video for ASMR purposes. And the reason why I am making this exception is for one simple reason, and that's because for me, it's authentic. I do this at home, and I do it in front of the TV. I don't watch what I'm doing with my hands, however, I watch the show. Whiskers and twist the ribbon, twist the end. Some of the best pops are on the end. Sometimes what I'll do is try to pull out the end. Doesn't straighten yet. But these little corners do the best pops. Yeah. I don't know about the rest of you, but home more because of the coronavirus, and therefore watching watching a little more television. So, therefore, playing with my Miles cat toy more. Because, well, I have told some of you that I am attendant for my local school district. Special needs children. And I was told when the coronavirus started that I would be staying home. Looking forward to going back to my job on the bus in August. Which means that I may pare down my videos to 2 videos a week instead of 3. And I'm sure that that's not a problem. Sharing it with as many people as are tuning in. But I'm so pleased and I'm so happy that I can help other people relax. And that is what I want. Now that I have seen how effective that ASMR is, I had to quickly try to explain that ASMR is a legitimate thing. But there are so many people in the world that are willing to compromise and do strange things just to entertain people and make money. Well, this is a little strange, I confess. But that would be because I am strange this way. But apparently not too strange because you're watching this video. You know what would be funny is if I ever had a visitor who said they loved ASMR. Instead of reading a story to them, I could just play with the little cat toys while they fall asleep. Tuck you in. Make your ears melt. Nostalgic smells. is like the scent or like taste. We experience so much of that in our youth or our childhood or even our adulthood that create memories. It isn't just what we think. It's everything we hear, smell, taste, feel. You feel this material and you hear the crinkling and you smell the fresh baked bread. It's all the same. And what it is it brings us to a place of almost euphoria because it's perfection. There are moments of life and love that we've had that were perfect. Weighted with love. The only difference being, then, of course, is that the sounds are or can be detached from the not sure what I'm trying to say. It's just that sound can affect you physically. But consider this. Perhaps smell can affect you physically as well. And we just don't realize it. Taste can affect you emotionally. Physically. Yes, I believe I'm making my own case for the physical and emotional sensations that our senses create for us. But with videos, all you get is visual and audio. Audio. Decided in a way. Now, wouldn't that be something if I could convey through video the fragrance of the candle that I have burning in my kitchen? Wouldn't it be great if I could convey to you the feelings and the emotions via the video? We got the sound. We got the sight. Well, I guess I've said enough about trivial things. Thank you to those who enjoy the soft-spoken and whispered videos that I do. I never, ever would have imagined that that is something I would have been appreciated for. They're not my most popular videos. But those of you who follow me for my voice, I thank you very much, because I still make a few pennies off of those videos, and honestly, I'm really, really really enjoying the money because it will allow my husband to retire soon. And it will be the first time in my life that I have made any real viable income apart from my job on the bus. I have been I was single for a little while as a mother, but I have been a stay-at-home mom all of my life. And didn't get the education that a lot of people wish or did get. So I'm not uneducated or unintelligent, but I do tend toward the creative and the arts. Nevertheless, I am not a artsy-fartsy person in the negative sense of the word. I don't follow names. Notoriety and things like that. I like what I like. And thank you for liking my videos. I'll sign off now. I hope you enjoyed this and I hope you sleep well tonight. Much love and hugs from me.